NFTs really are just as dumb as you think they are. Non-fungible tokens are links to some resource, usually an image, hosted somewhere else, that is assigned to a wallet. There is only one such token, and it can only be assigned to one wallet, technically, but not really. It doesn't stop someone from accessing the resource directly. It doesn't stop someone from copying the resource and creating their own link. It doesn't guarantee the resource will always even exist at that location. It doesn't guarantee that companies will allow you to trade them in their marketplace. It doesn't guarantee they are originals. It doesn't include any legal claims whatsoever. The basic idea is that people like to collect things, so why not collect digital things? The problem, obviously, is that digital things can be replicated perfectly, and collectors like things to be rare. So instead of making the thing rare, they are making the ownership claim to the thing rare. When you buy an NFT, you are not buying an image. You are buying a link to an image and hoping that other people will respect your link as the authoritative link. Thousands of other people could use the exact same link in a different NFT if they wanted to. I'm just going to pause for a moment and let that sink in. It really is that stupid. Some people are advocating for encrypted resources, so only the wallet owner would have the key to actually view the content of the image or whatever it's being linked to. But it's still hosted on other people's machines, and you'll no longer be able to brag about owning some ape in your Twitter profile without handing over the key. Also, how would that affect the price? Would you buy an NFT from someone if you had no ability to verify its contents beforehand? I guess you could trace the ownership back to the original mint, but why are we going through all this trouble for JPEGs again? Somebody might eventually find a use for NFTs. Tickets to an event is an often cited use case, but we already have digital tickets, so it's not clear what advantages we would derive from NFT-based tickets. But even if someone insists on using a decentralized blockchain to track ticket authenticity and ownership, there is no reason these things need to be purchased with crypto. If you really want to buy a link on some blockchain, the marketplace could easily accept payment in dollars and silently pay the gas fee in crypto, just like your credit card processor silently pays a fee without bothering you with the details. NFTs are actually smart contracts, but they don't have to be. Anybody could create a database of links to some resource, like a ticket hosted in IPFS, and declare your account to their service in the database as the owner. What benefit does anybody get from making such a service decentralized? Just like every other use case I've seen so far, anything you can do with a blockchain could be done better without one. NFTs are no exception. Regardless, people need to abandon the idea that these things are investments and start looking at them as tools to solve problems. To the extent they can be used for something useful, great. And I'm getting slightly tired of having to repeat myself in all these videos. Money laundering doesn't count. Unfortunately, like with everything else crypto, NFTs have descended into yet another fraud-filled grift. If you haven't seen Banksy's Exit Through the Gift Shop documentary, you should. There are parallels between NFTs and trendy street art auctions as depicted in this film. Not to spoil it for you, but it's centered on the extremely commercialized fake factory assembled art of Mr. Brainwash, being sold as if it was from a real artist. NFTs are also often extremely commercialized fake computer generated art being sold as if it was from a real artist, both designed specifically to make money with no other useful purpose. Not to communicate a message or even be pretty to look at, just money fueled by hype.